Well, hi, I'm Stephen Holt, and we have so many surprises for you here today on the Stephen Holt Show, the first new Stephen Holt Show of 2008. I guess this is our New Year's show, and I'm welcoming back T.J. Craig.
Hello, Stephen, how are you?
To the show, my famous co-host. We missed you, T.J.
I missed you, too. I guess I'm back from the dead, huh?
Oh, I hope not. Well, you're in the land of the living now.
Yeah, there you
go. Land of movies. It's called Hollywood.
Great.
And we're here with our two distinguished critics, super critics, film critics. Kenchenko is also making a comeback today. It's a day of comebacks. And also Merrick Burstick, who you haven't met yet.
No, I haven't.
It's going to be here. And we're all going to be doing our year's 10 best.
It's great. It's exciting.
Yeah.
It's the best time of year for movies, isn't it?
Yeah, and TJ and his mother kindly invited me over for Christmas, but it hasn't happened yet. Anyway, due to the magic of television, by the time you see this show, it probably will have transpired.
I'm sure it will.
And so will the New Year's. But anyway, TJ, you exist in a tradition of famous co-hosts who've been on the Stephen Holt television show. Now, of course, we're on YouTube 24/7.
I know, you're a big star now.
I know, and I'm still talking to you, isn't it?
I'm honored. I'm so honored.
And, well, you should be. No. But anyway, I mean, as you well know, there was Cuppy, and he isn't here today, and Scott Siegel also is not here through circumstances beyond our control. But we have a special guest who actually was the co-hostess of my show for 15 years, and you never met her, but she's in the actor's home out in Englewood, New Jersey. Her name is Judith Mayes, and she's now 96.
Wow.
She just had her 96th birthday, so when she taped what you're going to see, she was, well, considerably younger. And here's the first TV show that Judith Mayes ever did.
Hi. Welcome to the Stephen Holt Show.
And I'm Stephen Holt. Oh God, you'll never guess where we are now. Well, I'm not gonna tell you, but we've got a lot of surprises in store today. I think this is a puppet of me. Anyway, any people who've been watching the show all along will recognize this lovely original creation as one of the puppets of Judith Mayes. And guess what? Here she is. Hi, Judith.
Hello, Stephen.
Oh, thank you for having me up to your lovely little rustic country retreat
here.
You're
very welcome. It's just lovely up here.
Puppets like it up here. Well, now who is the? I mean, what is the?
Well, that is a little ballerina.
Uh huh. Mm-hmm.
So I always make several of those for my shows because they're great sellers.
Oh, are they?
The girls love them.
Uh-huh, mm-hmm. Uh-huh. This one has purple hair. I love it.
Well, and you've got for different colors of hair.
Right. Yeah, so do I. We're you're going to be coming back and visiting us a lot now, aren't you?
Yes, I think so. I think it's something like every week with a puppet.
Okay.
And a recipe, maybe.
And a recipe. Oh, you're working on some recipes now, too.
Yes, I have written a sing-along cookbook.
A sing-along cookbook?
All of the recipes are little songs.
Now, wait a minute, Judith. You sing these recipes
as
you're cooking
the song,
them? Is that the point?
Well, you can do that. You can. Or you sing them or entertain your friends beforehand, have a party and sing the menu.
Can you cook the recipes without singing? I mean, if you just want to cook?
Well, you could do that. You could do that. But they'll make you want to sing.
Oh, I see. And what are some of your biggest hits?
Some of my biggest hits are the tuna fish salad, and the turkey sandwich, and the moussaka rock.
The moussaka rock,
right.
There's mosquitoes up here that are eating.
This is the country.
Eating, I know.
It doesn't bother the puppets.
Right, no, it's bothering this one. So Judith, I'm really glad you brought me out here into the country with all these mosquitoes and this rain. Anyway, we'll do anything for you. Anything.
You
oh God, it's
healthy.
Really sick. You had to be healthy on this show. We've done too many interviews indoors in restaurants. So now we're doing one in the rain. I don't believe this.
That's lovely. Isn't that different? I don't mind at all. I'm getting my hair done tomorrow.
Oh, so good. Well, I don't have any hair, so it's So anyway, you know, it's just casting directors are all. a whole breed unto themselves,
yes,
aren't
they?
They
live their own lives, and you go tap, tap, tapping at the door, hoping they'll let you in.
Have you had a lot of experience with casting directors?
Oh, yes, I've had an experience with casting directors, but I don't mind them. I've been pretty lucky.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, you know something? I've got another surprise for you.
Yes?
We're going to go to a silly spot right now. Oh, and we're back to the biggest silly spot of them all on the Stephen Holt Show. You're in shock, TJ. You had never met Judith.
I've never met her. She sounds like an interesting person, to say the least.
She was delightful, yeah. And for years, she kept it a secret that her brother was a very famous screenwriter in Hollywood, nominated for Academy Award, but I won't reveal what his name was. But
you know, I have to say one thing. You don't look a day older.
Oh, boy, do you have this job for a long time. Well, anyway, Judith was a great inspiration and continues to be. She's 96, and oh, my God. She keeps going, and we got to keep going, too. Now, that inspires you to see how long that she was on the show for 15 years, so
wow.
You can just started.
There you go. I'm just a baby.